All right, put it on. Tell me what you hear.
Dogs. Cat.
Coming to you from the new Studio 6A, high atop the Meadowbrook building in marvelous Metro West Massachusetts. It's the Wicked Pissah Show. I'm Byron. I got Bumpa with me.
Hey.
And of course, as always, Rizzo.
What's up?
All right.
Oh, it's been a little bit since we've
had a show, yeah.
Way too long.
But we're back.
Rizzo.
What's up?
We've been waiting over there.
Dying.
The studio setup's been killing them.
We've been a young little tiger.
Yeah. A young little? There's nothing little about that.
That's true.
He's always little in his mind.
That's it.
All right, there might be tiger. Some little things to him, but for the most part, it's just...
We don't like to talk about those. No. Yeah.
What about the weather today? Cold out. That's all I got to say.
Yeah.
Cold.
It was.
It was like a teaser.
It wasn't too bad earlier, but then got pretty raw. Pretty raw. But it's it's been way too long since we've done a show. A lot of it's, we did move the studio from one inconvenient location to another semi-convenient location. But
well, it's fairly convenient.
Yeah, it's a better setting.
It's convenient for me. I just have to get up and come into the next room.
Rizzo's having an argument with Byron's cat.
Yeah, well.
So. Yeah.
I've trained that cat to specifically attach itself to crappy sweatpants.
No, I'm not feeding
it. Well, what's going on? What's new with you guys? What do you want to talk about? What kind of conversation do we have?
We've been just setting up the new studio, coming together. Everything, all the cables are all hooked up now, and it looks like we're going to be able to hopefully soon be going live on Spreaker.
Yeah, that would be nice. We know Rizzo's been dying to do live.
Live, baby.
So who knows? I mean, we could probably run a video camera in here, too. We've got enough room in this studio.
It would be nice to have a video camera, too, and then we'd be able to take some live comments and feedback from people. It'll definitely be an interesting show.
Definitely.
Hey, I got a question.
Question.
Here we go already. Hold on.
We're kind of PG-rated a little bit, but I think that husband and wife should have a sex holiday. I think that would really help relationships.
This was one of
those. I'm not a Dr. Ruth at all or anything, but
are you talking about a day off from it?
Yeah, like you call it at work, you would call it a husband and wife meet day.
No, but I'm talking about a holiday of sex. Are you talking to have sex or to refrain from sex?
Both. You could have done to be two holidays.
Why the? No. He is an interesting character.
I'm just thinking out loud.
I know, but the holiday. I understand the holiday, but
a holiday. Madonna said it best.
Right, but are you having the holiday to have sex?
Well, I think we need more love. So yeah, probably to have sex.
Okay, or to
all
not
the males
have.
Out there.
Right. At first, it sounded like
it's not a shopping holiday for the wife. No.
That's what tax-free holidays are for, right?
Exactly.
I got that conversation topic,
which leads me to my next topic.
Uh-oh.
But don't
Aaron
know.
Andrews
don't
and Hulk Hogan.
Aaron Andrews.
Oh, let me tell you.
No,
I would take nude pictures of Rizzo and send them to everybody for $27 million, $28
million. I think the problem was, I know you seem to put her on a very low grade. You don't think she's anything to look at.
Absolutely. But she's not the hottest thing out there.
I think the thing to look at, especially in that lawsuit, is that the pictures, the video, whatever, had, 30 million or 300 million views?
Views.
So that...
Well, yeah.
That tells you she's more than ugly.
Guy, nude sells. Nudity sells.
No. Yeah, but I mean...
I'm not saying she's ugly. I'm just saying she's not like...
Okay, so tonight, in a little bit, we're going to take a naked picture of you. I'm going to put it on.
Are we going to make $28 million out of this?
I don't know. How many views do you think you'd get?
Oh, I'd get views just because people are sick. They want to see. People want to know.
Byron's trying not to curl over there.
That's all right.
Trying to curl up.
We're in his homestead.
Awful.
I mean, there's a chance a picture of him could go viral.
Right, Hulk Hogan, he got 150 million.
It goes yelling.
I know. It's all yelling.
150 million, Hulk Hogan.
Yeah.
How do you explain that one?
I don't know.
He's 65.
Well, again, you have to remember he is a, he's a celebrity, though. The celebrity. If you weren't...
Oh, let's make Rizzo a celebrity, then we can do what we need to do.
Yeah, but you're gonna do it like the wrong way. You're gonna be more infamous than anything.
Absolutely not.
No.
No.
You know, you're just gonna bear it all.
What kind of guy you think I am?
I think you want Ron Jeremy status.
Yeah, well,
I love that. Ron Jeremy was a pretty known guy. There was a pause.
There was a little pause there.
There was a pause.
I had to think about that one.
Yeah, exactly. There was a pause. You had to think about that. Well, what's so bad about
Frankie
that?
Frankie Jeremy?
Before you know it, you're selling, erection pills, you know, stay hard pills.
You know, you're helping guys out that need help.
Oh.
Byron's back.
Yeah, had a fight with Kitty.
That cat was getting a little... It was not one of our sound effects. That was the actual cat.
Should I say what happened to me on April Fool's?
Oh, yeah.
Actually, yeah, this is a...
All right. Well, people, I'm in the shower. I'm taking my shower in the morning. And, you know, I'm drying myself. I come out of the shower and dry myself off. And I open the door to see my wife surprisingly in bed with the covers up to her neck. I'm like, oh, boy, this is a good one. No one's home. Time to make some sweet, love, passionate Rizzo love. So I go uncover the covers. She's got her coat on. She's got her shoes on and her pants. And she says, April Fool's, gotcha. I'm like, oh, that ain't right. Rizzo got smacked hard. Smacked down hard. Just wasn't right. That's not a good old April Fool's joke to do on your husband.
I think that was a funny one. I'm going to give that a golf clap, too.
I wasn't too happy.
Okay, so that's how many items scratch off of Rizzo's list?
A lot.
I know. Yeah,
well, what do you got, Byron? What mojo you got, pal?
Well, Bump and
they
I,
don't say sing it, bring it.
Well, Bump and I recently went out to a nice restaurant locally here in
Mario's.
Went in Hopkinton.
Oh,
and,
yes.
The Bison Burgers.
Oh.
Have you been there yet?
Good Bison Burger? Yeah, I've been to a Bison Burger.
Yeah, the one down in Milford, right?
There's one in Milford, but I haven't been to that one. I've been to another one in...
there's one in Hopkinton?
Medway, I might have been to the Medway.
Yeah, that's right, because they're closing the Medway location.
Milford. Closing Milford. Medway is open, I think.
Medway's open, okay. Yeah. Well, anyways, as far as that goes, the burgers, not only are they...
They're bison.
Know, lower in fat, they're lower in cholesterol, lower in carbohydrates, and it tastes
Westboro.
Pretty good too.
I've been to the one in Westboro.
I watched Bumpa just inhale a burger.
What's that, $10 burger?
It was probably something.
Yeah,
it was
expensive.
Definitely worth it though.
Yeah,
I give high marks on the service, the cleanliness of the place, everything top to bottom was beyond, you know. And then in another place we went to was out in Webster called The Lodge.
The Lodge, that was really good.
That was a very good meal. The steak was a little under-seasoned. The potatoes were a bit under-seasoned. But once you put your own taste in there, you're okay. It's a pretty good little place on Route 16, I believe it is, right?
Yeah, on the Webster-Douglas line area there.
What was that little bar we used to go to? Was that still there?
The Rose Garden?
The underneath bar?
Oh, the
Cellar Pub.
Cellar Pub. That's still there. It's in our business.
Long gone.
No, it's there, but I think it's switched hands a couple times.
Another Rizzo special of not getting into that business.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
Good call by Rizzo.
Excellent. Screwing that up.
Marketing was the key there.
Yeah, the lodge was good. You know,
the lodge was really good. We had... I can't remember. We had a drunk lady behind us who lost her keys.
Oh, yeah. She was adamant that we had them.
Free entertainment
I think she was
just
waiting for us to say surprise. We were kidding.
April Fool's. But it wasn't quite April.
Yeah. Byron and I get out quite a bit, probably too much, drinking and eating.
Yeah, we do.
So we do have a page that's kind of connected with the Wicked Pissah Show, the Watering Hole Critics and Reviews.
We invite all of you to come on, and if you have a place that you want us to review, if you own a place and you want us to review it, we'll come in and do it. Or if you just want to give, you know, your own thumbs up on something, or, you know, if you don't like it, we'll come out and we'll, you know, have a little taste of the food and let you know our honest opinion.
We'd welcome some fellow critics. You know, I could add you to the page if you're good at putting something together the first couple times. We'll just post what you share, and then... You know, if you do something good, we'll add you to as an admin or a moderator, you know, contributor to it. And you could also do some reviews.
More people on board with this, we could get this going. And, you know, the restaurant owners out there are really up on you know, what we're doing. They, the Buffalo place, you know, we told them afterwards.
The Buffalo place, the Bison Burger.
Bison Burger, yeah, Buffalo. Well, it's Buffalo. But Bison Burger, I mean, the owner was really nice and glad that, you know, we had a good experience there. So, I mean, it's...
Yeah, definitely recommend anyone try Bison Burger, whether it be the restaurant or just the meat itself, if you have a chance somewhere.
Definitely
good. Yeah, it's absolutely probably the best burger you ever have in your life. But that was good. That was a good experience. Like Byron mentioned, the lodge. Went to the lodge in Webster. Good food. I had a, what they call the Italian meatloaf.
Oh, yeah.
Absolutely delicious.
Bacon on that.
Bacon. We had sautéed mushrooms.
Sautéed mushrooms are good.
Delicious.
Mangi.
The Italian over here.
It's from the Flying Fat Gourmet.
But that was good. You know, we don't really get fancy drinks too often. We're beer kind of guys. The beer was cold, that's all I could say.
It looked like the mixed drinks were going up pretty fast. And it looked like they were well prepared, too.
Yeah, and the lodge, they are going to be doing some renovations soon, too. So.
Yeah, so get in there now if you want to get a good look at what it looked like to dine in the
70s. Yeah.
It's fantastic.
Old, but it's clean. It's clean.
Walked in there, the bar was sunken into the ground.
Yeah, a sunken bar, and so it was kind of weird to sit in a regular seat level type.
But it was comfortable for you, though.
I loved it. That was great. But there was another bar I've been to before. I've been there with Frank, Rizzo there. We went to Halligan's. Remember Halligan's?
Hooligans?
Halligan's. Halligan's in, right on the Auburn-Oxford line. Yeah, no, the bar was sat down, you're sitting in chairs type thing. That was good.
Definitely a fun time.
Yeah, it's different. But, hey, it is what it is. We had fun, good food.
Well, Frankie looks like he has something to say.
Well, we have to have a little two-minute little progress here for Mr. Frank, DJ Frank A., available for all DJ shifts, your parties, your weddings,
if you have
anniversaries. If
you
need a motivational speaker, if you need someone to just get your people motivated, let me be Frank into your school, program, work, business. We will get them motivated. Yeah. They will be a better employee because of Frank. So again, that's let me be Frank 101 at gmail.com. DJ Frank A. Look me up, and that will get you going too on a DJ pod. So again, that's my little news flash for today. Little promotion.
That would be
back to the
that'd be a plug. All his talk ever is self promotion.
Yeah. Self promotion, baby. Just like you guys, self promotion.
We're promoting nothing.
You just did. You promoted your new thing with Byron. What you guys are doing?
Actually, we've had that for about a year.
Yeah,
promoted it, so I had to promote.
To the show.
Mine's connected to the show. You get Rizzo.
DJing is not
Rizzo, Frankie, DJ Frank. It's all one. It's all one.
Oh, there we go. I know.
One segment guy. One, you get one product of all different.
Hey, I was at. All right, let's go. I was at Walmart earlier, and Walmart.
the cheap store.
World.
I got it.
Well, no. The part I hate most is you go into it and they have 25 to 30 registers, right? And like four open, and you got long lines, and it's like, why buy?
No one buys in stores anymore. They all buy online.
I know, but I don't. What I can't understand is why these stores set up so many registers. Each terminal's going to cost a couple grand.
They got too much money.
Why don't they just chop in half and save themselves $100,000? But
maybe you should go put in for CEO.
No. People talk about it. We'll go right into the minimum wage thing, a $15 fast food. I don't know what are you beeping over there?
That's just the department.
You're at the register. Oh. I don't have time for that.
What?
I have my wife buy this stuff. I don't go shopping.
You don't have the patience for anything.
Hell no.
You barely have patience to wait for your food to cook.
Yep.
It's raw and it's halfway in your mouth.
In-N-Out,
baby. Yeah.
The In-N-Out burger.
But, as far as the minimum wage thing, it's still, we talk about it all the time because
I'm going to get a raise soon.
It tears me up.
They want $15 an hour.
Yeah, I go.
Yes! Yes!
The other...
Yeah!
Jeez, you the there, other Frank A.
The other day, I went to McDonald's because my kids like the Happy Meals. So I go to get a couple of Happy Meals.
Uh-huh.
Still, every single time, I hate McDonald's personally.
They still got the toys?
The only thing I like out of... Yeah, they do sometimes.
What kind of toys? Anything good?
Right now, it's Matchbox.
Oh, you save one for me?
No, sorry. My kids love
it. I got to have something to play with.
But... they still screw everything up. They still screw up every order, regardless.
Yeah, well, I can't stand it, and I can't go in for, you know, if you're thinking about it, it's not an experienced job. Yes, does it suck to make that pay? Certainly does. Now, what really sucks is, you know, the people who are out there saving your lives, EMTs, contract companies, and all that stuff. They're getting paid $12.50 to, you know, $14.50 an hour.
I wonder, can you defibrillate yourself?
No, because you would pretty much be dead at the point you need defibrillation.
Just checking.
Okay. I mean, you could, but you'd probably kill yourself because you'd be alive. But
apply pads.
I wonder if that'd be called suicide.
We'd be glad to help you out.
Sure. That would be a good...
I think I
just solved a major... maybe I didn't solve it, but I brought forward a major lawsuit possibility here. Think about it. What about someone tries to save themselves but they die? Is it a suicide or not suicide?
It'd be suicide. Why else would you shock yourself with that kind of voltage?
I had no other choice.
Hey, Frank, you ever hear of a pacemaker?
Yeah. Well, maybe a person doesn't have a pacemaker.
That's what the self-shocking thing is.
I'm just saying. Roe versus Wade. You know, could be a new case.
Roe versus Wade.
I cannot believe the where he goes with this stuff. I'm lost for words. I mean, I don't know how he gets there.
Hug your child.
It's like someone takes a road map, a map of the world, crumples it up.
Go home and hug your child
and
then tonight.
He's trying to read it while it's crumpled up, and that's how we end up on the topics we're at. You know, I mean, we went from minimum wage to Roe versus Wade. I've lost.
How about WrestleMania 32? Anyone watch that?
I might.
No.
Here comes the money. Money, money, money.
My brain is just, you're just all over the disc tonight here. You know?
But anyway, like I said, they still screw up orders.
You guys are going to get the rock bottom soon.
My simple thought is that if you want to make better than minimum wage, get my order right. But like Byron said, it's not a job to make $15 an hour. Yes, does it suck to make that kind of money? Yeah. That's why you have ambition to do something else, something better. You move up, you learn. You know, if you're making 10 bucks an hour flipping burgers and that sucks, well, you know what? You work hard and make supervisor and make 11,
I'm,
12 bucks
I'm
an hour.
I'm switching my vote. I'm voting Bernie Sanders. He's going to bring that $15 an hour. He's going to bring, I think he's going to beat Hillary. I think he's going to be the next president of the United States, Bernie Sanders.
I think you got
problems.
It's
coming at first.
I don't take that side with Rizzo, and if you have hate mail, please send it to Rizzo only.
I have
nothing to do with it, what he just said. He's on his own there. I personally am a Trump supporter, but
I'm not
again. And I know a lot of people aren't sold on him yet, but I'm all for Trump.
Now, I don't know if he's going to get the delegates.
Trump is a businessman. He's going to try to run the country like a business, which I believe should be
done. Yeah, it needs
done.
To be done that way.
It just needs to be done that
it
way.
It needs to be done that way,
some,
at least for a little
while.
He
says some messed
change
up stuff,
things.
Though. He doesn't speak politically correct.
That's why he is where he is.
And that's why we're here where we are.
Oh, are we betting? Want to make a bet? Let's make a bet.
Final. It's
put your money with the mouth is. Let's make a bet.
Okay, Mario.
Let's make a bet.
I don't know.
I'm not going to gamble on politics. I care less that
much.
Let's
make a bet. A friendly wager. No. Come on.
We're good. Yeah, we
come
don't
on.
Have, you know, we,
what, you
don't? We don't have gambling problems. That's the problem.
I don't have gambling problems.
Oh, really?
Yeah, I don't have any money to gamble.
Right. But if you had 20 bucks and there was a $20 scratch ticket machine right next to you.
Well, guy, that's like saying an alcoholic going to get a case of beer.
Thank you.
It's possible.
It's possible.
See, I can say no.
Oh, Lord.
Yeah, right.
No.
Well, how about we were talking earlier, you know, Byron and I are here, we play Grand Theft Auto, GTA 5.
Oh, that's adult.
Need a little bit of sound effect.
And I bet you Tyler whoop your ass.
Not only is there some really foul language.
The biggest thing, we don't get that free time, you know, as we used to. But once in a while when you do, it's kind of cool to play together with the headphones. But you get the whole world of other people talking with you, and you hear like this in the background, you know. And yep, the other guy, you know, one
put the dog out.
Yeah,
and your kid's crying.
In a room
too.
With like 20 to 30 other people. And, you know, in a chat room, they call it. And, yeah, you got, you know, baby crying in the background.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, mom, 5 more minutes. You know, you get the kids screaming. You know, it's just so fuck
and
you.
And the most foul, racist language out there.
Yeah.
I won't even go into.
Oh, yeah, all the N-words, you know, calling you this, calling
and
you that.
And their kids, too, that are doing that.
Well, how old are you? 9? He's sitting there. He's threatening my life.
I wish there was a way that you could set up a room with adults.
Yeah.
Adults who are playing the game just a couple hours.
Yeah,
here
I mean,
or
you
there.
Could, you know, individually mute people, that sucks you. Then you're constantly doing it.
Well, I spend about an hour muting all the jackasses.
When you get older, you like alone time.
Well, we know Frank does.
I know. That's a problem, you know. Rizzo's,
I like my quietness.
That's very hard to believe.
You say until April Fool's Day comes around.
Oh,
and then you're very upset about that.
Very, very upset.
Yeah.
It's just a cruel thing to do to your husband.
But, yeah, if your kid plays Grand Theft Auto and has the headset and talks to the people, you need to know that.
Oh, you don't even need to have the headset, if you know what I mean.
No, you don't need to. We're not talking about the game itself. We're talking about the social aspect of the game. With the headphones and microphones, people can talk to other people around the world.
Oh, yeah,
on
if
it.
You're online, yeah.
Right, you're online gaming with it. You need to understand that, you know, what the things your kid's hearing. You know, maybe you might not be hearing your kid say anything. Maybe he only has a headset, doesn't have a microphone, which is fine. But other people
still
are
hear it. Yeah.
Yeah, other people are saying all kinds of nasty stuff, and it's crazy. But then at the same time, so are some of the 10-year-old kids out saying some of that stuff out there too. And then, you know, there's some of the funny stuff, but it gets annoying. Byron says the chips, you know, you hear the dog barking in the background, and, you know, the other person that's playing apparently is the father yelling at the kid, let the dog out.
Oh, yeah.
But he's too busy playing the game, you know.
Get the meatloaf!
Exactly. You know, you hear that. You hear the kid, a baby crying, you know, and just... And
is
people,
that Byron playing Atari? It sounds like Byron playing
exactly,
Atari.
Exactly.
No, but this is...
Alone, you faggot.
I mean, right. This is the kind of stuff that you hear.
Yeah. And excuse that terminology.
Oh, look, someone's fucking car. Don't mind if I do.
Right. And
it's awful. And
that,
it's
that's
all you
actual,
hear.
That's the video clipping, right?
Yeah,
I'd stomp on that game.
Yeah.
my right boot.
Do you even play games?
No.
I'm straight hardcore, bro.
Straight hardcore. Right from the couch, he's live.
That's
straight
it.
Hardcore. Live from the couch.
Live from the couch.
These hands do a lot of pushing, baby. A lot of pushing.
And, you know, well, at some point, I bet this show will get to that where we have, there's the three of us, but it's going to be Byron and I here and Rizzo at home on a couch with a headset on.
Oh, I'll be mobile. Once we go that way, I'll be on a headset.
No, we can do that, though, actually, through the Spreaker
Bluetooth.
Thing. My friend runs, now this is just a little something, my friend runs his Spreaker show, and which is what I want to get
you
us
say
into.
Speaker show?
Spreaker.
Spreaker.
Yeah, S-P-R.
S-P-R.
Okay. Yeah, S-P-R.
Yeah.
It's like speaker, but with an R in it.
My friend is in Georgia, and his friend is in Washington, D.C., and... Yeah. It sounds like right here where we're sitting in the same room.
It'll be like McDonald's, can I have your order?
Oh, pretty much, yeah. You'll be on your phone and complaining that it's taken up your minutes.
But that's the problem.
I got unlimited minutes.
But that's the problem. We can't let that happen to Rizzo, because what's going to happen is you're going to have a moment or two of silence and you're going to hear a toilet flush.
There's that. Or, I mean, he's already
bodily
dressed.
Functions are part of human anatomy.
But not while you're on the radio.
Yeah.
Hey. You'd be surprised what happens on the radio.
He's having a fight with his wife or kids. Fuck,
oh, get the meatloaf!
Oh, I can see it now.
Oh. But,
this
man. Yeah. You got some good news, though, man. Are you moving on up in the world?
I got a new job. Okay, yeah. I got a new job, but I got an interview for another job, which I got an interview for another job. So I think by next week I should have a job.
There you go. That's a good way to look at it.
Yeah, I'm stepping up with my jobs. But, going from parking attendant to head nurse.
But right now you can find him as a janitor in the... in one of the buildings in Milford. He'll be cleaning up all the public restrooms.
Who can it be?
Make sure you tip
now?
Him when he come by.
Oh, I take tips.
Dollar bills only, please.
Tips.
But, yeah, you know, it's...
It is what it is.
Exactly.
You gotta love what you do. Everyone has a purpose. You gotta find out what your purpose is.
The jerk. Remember that, your special purpose from the jerk? No. Okay.
No.
Well, Frankie, you got any other topics for us today?
Who
was expecting that voice?
Miracle marijuana coming to you soon. I think by 2020, you will see it in all 50 states.
Nope.
I think you will. Rizzo's going in and starting the factories up. Oh, yeah, Milford's got a factory.
No.
Oh, yeah, call it the marijuana factory. Pound put it through.
All well, right. That's for the medical stuff.
Medical marijuana. You have to have a medical marijuana card.
Uh-huh.
Yes, and you know how hard that is?
Probably
it's
hard.
Not very hard at all.
You
go to a special doctor, and that doctor charges you, what, a couple of $100, charges it to your insurance.
But again, you can get a card for your use. You can get a card for personal growth, which is extremely limited.
Personal? Go back. Personal growth, like what? Like I'm going to have a greenhouse effect?
No, you can have a few plants. That's about it.
Plants are on my bathtub?
Well, no, if you're looking to be the grower.
Is this a new thing that you're a pothead now?
No, never done drugs. Don't do drugs. Don't believe in drugs.
Yeah, the license itself.
I throw my drugs away.
The license itself is $50,000 annually to the local community.
Oh, that's the incentive.
Yeah, to the local community. But then, of course, you know, the equipment is going to cost you...
Hundreds of thousands.
Yeah. I mean, you need to have some serious capital just to start that. And there are very tight controls on everything. You know, whether or not it'd be worth it, I don't know. You might not even be able to put the money in the bank. So you have to make all cash deposits. So
that gets police involved, guns involved.
Oh, yeah. It just wouldn't be worth it, I don't think. And anyway, I do not see all 50 states going to it.
I do.
Because the some of the states that do have it have seen issues with it. A lot of
Colorado hasn't had too many issues with it. But
it's not. But if you do some research, it's not as smooth as they play it off as. Same thing with California. You know,
California's a nightmare.
Yeah.
And what's going on is the organized drug dealers. You know, the cartels and stuff like that from Mexico are coming up, and they're starting to raid these medical marijuana shops. And you don't hear about that ever.
No.
But the news is only going to report what's sensational to them, and that's not quite sensational enough. So. Yeah.
Well, I mean, that's the thing, too, is what state law allows is one thing, but doesn't mean it's federally legal either. So that's why sometimes a lot of things, the state might allow it, but the feds will come in and do something.
Yeah, so, true.
You know, like... The thing is, especially like in Mass, in some states, pipes or whatever paraphernalia is outlawed. In Massachusetts, only the sales of paraphernalia is outlawed. The sales of the pipes or whatever is outlawed. Possession is not outlawed. You can own a pot pipe. There's nothing against owning a pot pipe.
Don't tell my wife that.
There is a federal law against it. She may not. It may not have any state. But
so this means if you go over state lines, now you're in federal lines.
No, it's federal. Where any 50 states, she's violating federal law.
Technically, right. Now.
You sound like Rubio now talking about lines.
There's no lines. You're the one brought up lines. I'm not
lines is lines.
Yeah, he said, she crossed the state lines. That's
isn't
a federal.
It state lines or is it federal?
There are state lines, but that doesn't mean anything.
Where's the federal lines?
There is no and all
the border.
Those
are imaginary.
Ocean.
Imaginary?
No. The federal line, quote, is the entire country. Anything on U.S. soil.
You circle that up.
Anything in U.S. soil is federal government.
All right, so if I take a pipe from Massachusetts and go to Rhode Island, where it could be illegal, I could be in trouble. Legally. You could, because Rhode Island might not have the law, and Mass does have the law.
It doesn't matter.
Oh, another example, like Denver, you can go and buy, because of Colorado, you can buy drugs.
No, because it's against federal law, it doesn't matter what the state laws are. It's against federal law. You violate federal law.
So why do the states have a law?
Because some have, it's additional penalties, basically. Some have state law, you're violating state law. You know, it's like drunk driving is a state law, but it's not a federal law. It's not a, there's no state drunk, think about it. Drunk driving is a federal, is a state law, but not a federal law. It's not enforced on a federal law, federal court
level.
Are all
states have laws?
Different, yeah, but they're different. They're like different punishments, you know, different.
So the DUI in Mass is different than DUI in Oregon?
Can very well be. It can very well
be. Right. Typically, they're 0.08.
Yeah, but there are different elements to those laws as far as...
All right, hold on. So in Colorado and Washington, it's state legalized that you could have marijuana, correct?
Medical marijuana.
Correct, right?
Right. But if you say you don't have a medical marijuana card,
it's illegal.
You still can't have it.
In Colorado and... Right. So right, you got to have the proper...
Let's go
exactly.
to the...
Exactly. And then even on the card, you're still limited to how much you can have on your person.
Well, if you go on YouTube on February 9th, Rizzo put a spot about marijuana stocks, things that I think are moving. There's a company called Pissah and another company called MJNA. And also, if you look, Rizzo put a buy recommendation on Tesla at 145. Well, Tesla today is at 245. I just want you to all go maybe look me up on YouTube, Frank Andreotti, and look up my photos and look up what I put, and it's all dated. So just this, I wanted to give that little info out there.
This is like the most, yeah, the most conflicting, contrasting type thing I've ever heard. We go through from medical or miracle marijuana.
Miracle marijuana.
To buying Tesla stock.
I just thought I'd put it with the marijuana
again,
stuff.
Again, the roadmap just taken, crumpled up.
Yeah. Hey, you were going and through then, federal lines.
I never said
state lines.
It's
imaginary lines.
Anywhere in the United States of America.
You sound like Rubio.
Anywhere in the United States of America is federal. You have to follow. You have there.
So is Puerto Rico federal?
Yes. Puerto Rico is
the
United States.
I didn't know the Puerto Rico is Puerto Rico a state?
No.
No,
but it's territory.
Territory.
So
like all the
civics,
Guam, all
still,
those
right.
are like...
They have their local laws, but they're still subject to federal laws.
Cuba not too, right?
No, Cuba is not no. a... Cuba is its own country.
They're a sovereign nation.
They're on their own country.
Okay, hold on a second. Really.
Good, great, great.
This,
good
today's civics lesson was brought to you by Frank A.
The DJ!
So yeah, the same
spinning
guy.
The ones and twos.
In the end, the end-all be-all is the federal government still says marijuana is illegal, whether it's you have to have a federal tax stamp for it. And the only people who have the federal tax stamp is the federal government, and they're not giving it to anybody. So it's still all federally illegal.
Yep.
So you're saying I have a better shot of getting $15 an hour than I do of getting medical marijuana card in Mass?
Yeah.
Oh, right. I'll take that. I'll take the $15. Thank you.
You can already marry your right hand.
Deal or no deal?
Well, getting a medical marijuana card for you to smoke pot is not that hard.
Sure, if I have back issues and I have other mental issues?
I could break your pinky right in this table here, and that'll probably qualify you. You got pain in your pinky. Okay.
Thank you.
But again, you're limited to how much you can have. You have to buy from dispensaries. You can't go buy from Guido. You know,
it sounds like a lot of loopholes in there. I think
there are no loopholes. That's the problem. People think there are loopholes. Loopholes are open gaps. There are no gaps. That's why Massachusetts took a long time to come out with it. It's very controlled. It's very strict rules. You cannot, it's not. There's no like you're saying over there. You can't. There are things you cannot do. And if you don't,
but people go behind.
Hey, there's a gentleman here for Frank.
I'm just saying. People go around laws. They break
I know that
laws.
That's right, and they're breaking laws. Okay, you don't need a medical marijuana card to go get pot. You just go down to the local dealer and get it now.
Right.
So okay, but the thing with the card is, as long as you follow the rules,
you can get it.
There's no conflict. There's no
right.
consequences.
There's no conflict.
For it.
There's no. You can't get arrested or
exactly. But if you violate the rules of it, you get arrested. That's the whole purpose of it.
So people need to know the rules.
Right. And then it's a whole taxation thing. People say, well, make it legal and tax it. You know, I disagree with it.
Representation without taxation?
I disagree with it because, all right, say you're a big-time pot dealer, okay? And now they legalize it. Oh, suddenly you're going to file your taxes about all your drug sales? You know, because it's legal, so you can't get in trouble for it. But suddenly you want to pay taxes on your extra 50 grand you're making? Yeah, you want to pay taxes on that?
I would think they do.
No, you're going to be taxed on it. That's the whole point of legalizing it overall. They want to
So the states get their money.
They want to legalize it, right. So they're going to tax it. Now, they're going to leave out, you know, like I said, is Bob the drug dealer going to say, yep, I made 50 grand in sales, so tax me on that?
I don't think they are.
So, no, they're not going to have any, there's no integrity in the system whatsoever. You know,
there's no checks and balances of who's doing it.
If you have to stop paying taxes on your drug sales, you're going to have to bump up your money a bit, the cost, so you can make up for that.
Right.
You know, because instead of making 50 grand, now you're only taking in 30 grand.
Right.
So you're going to have to bump that up. So now
the cost goes up to
Joe's. Right. Blow. But then, so you find the other dealer down the street who's not following those rules because he's not claiming it on his taxes. So now he's making a 50 or 60 K without paying taxes. But you being the good drug dealer and paying your taxes, you're getting bumped out by the other guy. You know, it's stupid because people are not going to suddenly, you know, start keeping track, full receipts. Hey, here's your 3 pounds of pot. You know, this is what you paid for it. This is the taxes, and I'm going to pay the taxes on it. Because that takes away from the whole point of being a drug dealer, to make money. You know, you're gonna stop paying taxes on your drug sales.
That's why they put laws around it.
Right. Well, that's what pharmaceutical companies are for. You know what I mean? And, you know, a lot of people talk about how it's not a gateway drug. It is a gateway drug. It's not a gateway drug to everybody because some people, you know, they might use pot and that's it. You know, but for some people, they use pot for pain and frustrations. You know, now, after a while, the pot doesn't do it. They need something a little heavier. So they start doing other drugs. And that's how it ends up become a gateway drug.
I eat Fiber One in the morning.
That might be a drug for you.
Yep.
Just like
it's not a drug. It's a death sentence for you and me. It's, you know, we have to sit in a room with him, and now we can't wait until we go mobile because then he's going to be on the toilet.
I can't wait for mobile. I'm going to have one of those GoPro cameras on top of my helmet.
Oh my god!
Because he already wears a helmet. You know, when
it has two sides. It has milk and water.
He's special.
Be mobile. He'll be talking about in our conversation.
Crunching.
He'll be talking in our conversation with the GoPro on. So while he's talking on conversation, you'll watch the video and see him making a peanut butter jelly sandwich.
Absolutely.
You know,
or doing something awfully, awfully wrong.
Oh, yeah. Well, hopefully he'll know better to shut the camera off at that point.
No, he won't.
Oops, no, I forgot.
He has a hard time with his TV. It's
Lem chops.
What else did you want to talk about, bud?
Oh, definitely want to talk about the Patriots coming out, draft coming out.
Yeah.
They got 11 picks, five of them in the sixth round, two of them in the seventh round. I think you're going to see them trade up and maybe trade some of those sixth-round picks and get some good guys. The team, they signed a lot of free agents. Yeah,
some good signs. Yeah.
Good signings, and I think they're going to have a great team this year.
Yeah.
If they can keep Brady healthy and he doesn't get a four-game suspension, they'll be all right.
Yeah, but they did a lot of solidified the team all around. You know, as far as strengthening some of that. And I'm glad they did restructure Amendola, right?
Yeah, so they can keep him.
That was good.
Got to say my cousin Chrissy Colabello for the Toronto Blue Jays.
Please do not tell him. No, Chris Colabello is not Chrissy. Please.
Well, you know what?
Please.
I'm Frankie to you. I might be Frank to some. I can call anyone as I wish.
Chrissy is a girl's name.
This is the Frank...
I think you need to have a heart to heart with your.
I don't need to have a
heart to heart. Cousin Chris.
I don't need to have a heart to heart. He's good. He's Chrissy too to me.
I know you call him Chrissy,
love.
But you might want to ask.
Chrissy
him.
Means love.
You should ask him if he likes to be called Chrissy because that's a girl's name.
I'm sorry.
It is.
Do Richard like to be called Dickie? I don't know.
Yeah, I know.
You
know? Yeah.
Some, you want to be called Dick do. Or Richard? I don't know. You want to be called Frank or Frankie? You want to call
you Frank Dick?
There you go.
All right. I have a Dick serious is Frank. Question that I feel that needs a little bit of answering.
What?
It seems as though I've run into a few Franks in my life.
Just a few?
And most of them all say they speak about themselves in the third person. Is this a normal thing for a Frankie to do?
I think it's a normal thing for an Italian, right?
I try to take myself out of a normal equation.
I don't know. You often, you know, you do. I don't think you do it, like, intentionally.
This is fantasy today. This is fantasy land. Wait, this isn't candy every day land. It's fantasy land. Land. You.
It is. Every day
this ain't
land.
Real. No, this ain't real. Life ain't real. It ain't real. It's not real. It's got tangible and intangible assets.
If you
things
could
you can
just
touch,
see,
things you can't touch.
If you could just see how bright his eyes are right now.
I bright up like a Christmas tree, pal.
I really don't even know what he's talking about.
Neither do I.
99.99% of everybody else in this world has screwed up a
just
body.
Go with it. Just go yeah. with it.
If you don't agree with them, you're wrong.
Just go with it. Feed the poor, okay?
There you go. That's Frank.
Back I was saying
out.
Chris Colabello for the Toronto Blue Jays.
Yeah.
Been playing every day.
Excellent.
I don't know if he played today. I think they lost today. I think they might have lost Josh Donaldson, too. I think he put a hammy today going to first base. You know, I'm home a lot, so I get to watch TV, like MLB and, you know, order from Amazon and, you know, dressed up as Darth Vader.
Oh,
I get to do a lot of things.
Put a dirty sock over your mouth and talk it, breathe heavy?
Nah, that's too much for me. Almost like my wife says I need to have the, what's it called? The thing when you have, can't sleep at night, the machine?
The sleep apnea.
Apnea. Yeah, I'm almost ready for that.
PPAP or
something? PPAP, yeah, I'm almost ready for that.
I'm surprised he's not on it.
I'm waking
now,
myself up in the middle of the night.
During the day, you know, just to help
him. Do you guys drool in the middle of the night? Like, I got to rinse out my pillow.
I think everybody does to some degree, not always.
I drool bad.
Nope.
Well, if you watch the way he sleeps, like a corpse, you know what I mean? We've traveled
just
together.
Just as
pale
as one.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah, I'm not like that.
You know how, like, a person lays in the casket?
Yeah, that's right, how he lays?
That's how he sleeps, yeah. Oh,
like a death person?
Oh, dead.
Dead, absolutely
not,
dead.
Not a death person, but...
Yeah.
That's dreamy. At least he's getting ready.
Well, and you know, like, he's white as it is. So, in the morning, you know, he's like, he looks dead. He's like, it's like, that's how Vampire fell asleep last night. That's how Dracula fell asleep. That's.
I cannot lay on my back and sleep. I gotta lay to my side or my other side.
No.
I can't lay on my back.
Well, I sleep all sides.
Yeah, I move
like
a full.
Yeah, you're all access over there. You're just
all access.
I wake up and I hear this rustling in the bed next to the next door, and it's like oh,
flipping
then,
like a pancake.
Of course, we had that when we were out in Vegas with Frank A. I don't know how poor, your brother-in-law there.
Just, he fell down once by accident.
Yeah, but the way that you were snoring, you were shaking a wall. The TV
that's
was
what I'm
rattling,
saying. Like, I need some sleep apnea in
here. It
didn't bother you at all, right?
I don't know. Nothing. I'm in Star Wars land.
Oh. Yes, he is.
Oh.
Yeah,
hey, guys, see any new movies recently? Or?
I watched that show Billions. I like that show.
Yeah.
Some Byron about it today.
Yep. Showtime, right? The
Showtime. 10 o'clock on Sunday nights.
Yeah.
Yeah, the hype over Batman versus or Superman versus Batman.
Yeah,
don't even bother seeing it.
Who wins?
I didn't even watch the end of it. It was that.
I'm gonna go with Batman.
It was the only bright. Affleck actually did a good job as Batman.
I think when you go to see a movie like that, you oftentimes try to connect the dots with let's say the comic book or the history of it. You know.
And there was none of that.
Yeah, I think the way things are today, remade five times over, you have to go with a complete open, forget the history.
Marvel does a good job keeping with the timeline, and when they need to reinvent something, they just go ahead and do it, and they don't overthink it. DC is overthinking everything, so, it's, I think Rizzo's getting a little antsy.
Tick-tock.
Yeah.
He's checking the time. We're at 43 minutes now. So.
Oh, yeah, baby.
Beer
nuts.
Frank's nuts.
Wow.
How do you like these nuts? Oh, let me tell you the joke my son said to me today, the other day.
Your son?
That's a good one. Oh, yeah. Why did the chicken cross the road? To get to the little bitch's house. That was nice, Tyler. That was a good one my son did today. Unbelievable. It's unbelievable. See what they're learning in the school systems, Ty?
Yeah.
He comes home with all A's. I can't even get on the kid.
Oh, God.
All right, let's try to get back on the... All right, as far as
Byron, there you are.
TV goes. Yeah.
Look at Byron. He's resting peacefully.
I can't wait till we get a camera and get to do some of this live. I'll put the cameras in the corners of the room and go with that.
I'm on a GoPro right on. I want to have one of those like one of those station
you
helmets.
You can't afford a GoPro.
Hey, oh yeah, I can. Oh, I will.
You can.
I'm going to get a drone and fly it over here.
A drone. And then he's going to bitch about having to register it with the FCC or the FAA.
Get a plane. The plane.
He's definitely not right.
Well, left.
No, he's never been right, but you know,
yeah. I'm more normal than you two put together.
He's all right. See, he is more normal than everybody, even his family. Everybody's wrong but him.
Absolutely.
They'll bring my family too. They got their own issues.
Yeah, here we go. Everybody's got a problem with him.
They do.
Oh.
It's not me.
Nope.
I tell you.
Frank, I was born on the right side of the tracks.
Rizzo is perfect.
Never said that. Never said that.
All right, then what
never
is
said
he?
I was perfect.
But you're never wrong.
No, I didn't say that either. When I'm wrong, I'll admit it.
Oh,
I haven't been wrong lately, but I'm wrong, but I'm not wrong lately.
It's kind of like I thought I was wrong once, but I was mistaken.
No.
Somebody get a rim shot.
When I'm wrong, I'll admit it.
All right, we'll hold you to that.
Yeah. Okay. I don't know what I'm wrong with yet lately, but just like I said.
Do we have any other Frankie stuff?
What else we got today? The joke. What's that? I'm trying to think.
Well, we got a lot of dead air going on right now, so we might as well jump back in on something. What else can we talk about? Hey, we're at 46 minutes, and
we came ill prepared. I think we're more excited that we have the studio finished up.
Yeah,
for the most part,
it's finished up. We've got to hide the wires, and
and now Frankie wants to play the pussy on the floor somewhere.
Yeah,
but I got to keep him away from that cat.
Yeah,
I already attacked him once, so the cat's got good taste.
How did you manage to tick off that cat?
I touched your cat. I didn't touch the cat.
No, you...
Skin a cat?
The cat touched you, though, right?
Dude, it's like it's claws into me.
No, the cat
like,
never
bitch,
done
please.
That to me.
That's like, bitch, please.
I
think somehow you gave off a bad vibe to that cat.
That cat knows people.
The cat reminds me of the girl in Vegas that I gave all my change to that. She freaking wanted to kill me.
Let me tell you this, though. If you ever support Bernie Sanders again... I'm going to unfriend you on Facebook.
Yep.
Unfriend me.
Okay.
You put too much shit on there anyway.
Oh.
I get comments from you back home. I get comments every day. Keith's putting more shit on Facebook. Facebook. Does he work? Does he live?
Yep.
Wow.
I don't know how to use it.
Okay, everybody. Sorry.
You
I
see,
should have had
how often
guys,
you see me on there?
Turn that
you
down.
You see me on it a lot much?
No, because you're surfing for porn.
No, I'm not. You can check my phone. Check my records, pal.
Let's check
I don't know
records.
What you're doing in the middle of the night besides
working.
That's warmed over.
If we play the previous show we recorded, you will mention that you're on Facebook all day long and you still can't keep up with it.
That's true.
I'm not on Facebook all day long.
No, we will find that previous show where you said.
I'm not on Facebook all day
yes,
long.
That's
and
not
we will
said.
Start, we'll
that's
start
not
the next
said.
Show.
No.
Yes, it is.
No, you go find it.
Every time I'm on it, I can't keep up. I can be on it all day long,
yep.
And I can't keep up.
I check my Facebook once a day. That's not all day long. Now you're defining how often I'm on Facebook? Put it this way. I'm a lot less than you two put together on Facebook.
Okay. But
It's like drama. I'm not into drama.
Drama.
I don't have to be into the drama to be on Facebook.
I'm just saying. There's a lot of drama on Facebook. That's all.
Only if you let it be drama.
Yeah. I don't let it control what I do. That's all.
I don't either.
You don't see me on there that often.
Well,
that's
I got a
saying.
Question. I have a question for Frank.
I don't understand why it's a...
You don't see me on there. You don't see me posting
I don't even
stuff.
Know why it's a topic.
It is.
What do you do all day long?
What I do?
Nothing.
It's none of no one's business.
It's none of no one's business. A double negative, so that means it's all of
our
business.
Exactly. It's all positive.
Well, he's got to keep
right.
it down.
Two negatives equal a positive.
He's got to keep it down because he doesn't want his wife to know what he's not is
doing. I'm very open.
Yeah.
Except
no
problem.
For,
you can put a camera on
wait,
me all day.
Wait, wish you would. Wait a minute.
Wish you would.
I do not want
hold
to.
On
I wish you would.
Hold on.
Scratching
I wish
your
you
balls.
Would.
Scratch your bald watching 16 candles.
Hold on a
doesn't
second.
Matter.
Didn't he just say
Goonies,
it's
get
not,
it right.
none of no one's business?
Chuck!
I believe he said it was none of business.
Right. If you can't understand that, then go to Facebook.
He said, I wish people would follow me around all day long. You know what I'm going to do? I'm going to follow him around all day
long. And I'm going to
broadcast it live. I'm going to hook up to his Wi-Fi.
You ain't got no dirt on Uncle Frankie.
No, I will bring up one subject.
Yeah, you can bring it up.
It has nothing to do with you, so you'll be all right.
Oh, that's good.
Okay.
I have to defend myself 2-1 as usual.
Oh, you don't. You make it every time.
No.
Like you brought up Facebook. We didn't bring anything up about Facebook.
If it doesn't fit, you must have quit.
He makes it a subject. That's weird.
If it doesn't fit, you must have quit.
Against what?
Against you.
We're not talking about anything.
All right, change the channel. Go into your subject.
I'm trying, but you won't shut
up.
Try.
Go ahead. I'm waiting.
We
bell slippers on.
To quit or whatever the hell you're saying over there.
Too legit to quit.
Anyway, okay, that's some dead air there.
Yeah, no, I know. It's all right. I'm chewing the peanuts all. Okay.
You want to choke?
Yeah, I don't want to choke.
All right.
But anyway, you know, the small business I work for, at one time the owner had sought like a loan or whatever. Well, apparently whoever signed up for has, you know, sold that information. They're getting calls all day long. Hey, we can help you out with your funding, this, that, and that. Well, anyway, and one day I answered the phone, my favorite one to date yet. This guy with a New York New York City accent, God. Either from Brooklyn or the Bronx.
Almost as bad as
Hey, this is Anthony from Blue Collar Funding, right? Just like that. An Italian New York guy, all right?
And sounds like someone I know.
Yeah, and it's like you can hear a bunch of people in the background. You can just tell it sounded like it was something that was mob operated in a basement in Brooklyn or the Bronx. And
we got decent rates.
Yeah, we got really good rates. We can help you out. And we had that whole accent, and it was like, oh my God, yeah, thanks, Anthony. But we're all set. All right, well, keep us in mind if we can help you out. You know, it's like, thank you. He was a nice guy, and at first I really didn't think anything of it. And I hang up, and I'm just like, are you friggin' kidding me?
Telemarketers have just moved on to just anybody and everybody. Well, those lists that are out there.
Yeah.
It's awful that they're just calling you all day long. Now, I sleep all day long.
Yeah.
And so my phone rings.
So we know what you do all day.
A couple of times, yeah.
Because he works all night.
Because I work all night.
That's good. Well, you're working, I'm sleeping.
I think you're doing something.
Sleeping.
Snoring.
I get my sleeping.
Hey, but that do not call list. I think, was
that
it Maine?
To, throw that out the window.
No, there was a state recently that fined a company big money for
They don't go after, how Wiley. Often they go after them? They probably don't go after them that much.
Well, not a lot. But
it's up to the individual states.
Yeah. Most of them are out of country anyway.
Well.
Most of the ones I get are out of country. Jamaica.
Well, there's a reason for that.
I have never had anyone from out of country call me.
I get out of country all the time.
You know why he does?
You know, the phone number might come out of country because they make it that way.
Yeah.
Yeah, they make it that way. You can get something from somebody like who's actually New York.
They sound like they're out of country. They're India, Jamaica.
I could spoof his phone and be calling people with his cell phone number.
Hello.
867-5309. Go ahead.
Hello. Would you like a soda machine?
Squishy.
I won the lottery.
Well, I got the slush for you.
All right, so we're at
all right. Well, thanks for joining
minutes.
Us.
I think we're going to call
Rizzo's
this.
Rizzo's got to go to bed.
Yeah,
Rizzo's getting grumpy.
I know. Yeah, Rizzo, you grumpy from the get go.
Now, mind you,
I'm grumpy.
Took too long to
people
set
make
up.
Them grumpy.
But, you are because you start directing things the wrong way. That we're ganging up on you, and you just—it's
all right.
We have no idea what the hell you're talking about.
I stand alone. I'm okay. See? I have no problem defending myself.
From what?
I just have to.
All right, on this note,
I'm a fighting force.
We're going to call it.
Nice. May the force be with you.
God.
All right, don't forget.
Hey, Rizzo.
Yeah, brother.
I love you.
Love you too, brother.
Thanks for listening. We got watching
thanks for listening. Who knows?
Someday you'll watch.
We may not even post this one. Yeah. Hey. We might. We may not.
But, hey, thanks for listening to the Wicked Pissah Show.
I'm Byron.
I'm Frankie.
It's been Wicked Pissah.
And there's Bumper.
Old man.
the Wicked Pissah Show.